Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today I have a foundation review for you on the Makeup Forever HD Foundation Stick. I've been wanting this and I finally got it. It came in the mail, so I'm gonna do my first impression and review video for you. I did promise that I would have more reviews in 2016, so I'm kicking it off with a foundation review, and so many people have been raving about this and loving it, so I'm so excited to try it. So some of the claims for this product: it's supposed to give you invisible coverage, so it's gonna look very natural on your skin but still have that medium to full coverage. It's lightweight, long lasting, and comes in a ton of different shades. I believe like 15 different shades. So I love that it is in a stick formula. So if you are like a makeup artist, you would be scraping this. So you probably wouldn't get as much bang for your buck if you're putting this in a kit. But if you're just using it on yourself, I always find that a stick form, it's easy to travel with, it's fun to use, and it's just super easy because you can put it all over your face and then blend it out. So the color I chose is color 127 or Y335. This product does only contain 0.4 ounces in it, which is like less than half of what you typically get when you're purchasing a liquid foundation like of this size. So this is how much comes in there, which doesn't look like that much, but maybe a little goes a long way, so we'll see. So let's go ahead and jump into the demo. So I always wear a primer, at least when I'm doing something special. I like to wear primer. So I am gonna apply the Makeup Forever Step 1 Smoothing, and I'm just gonna apply it to this side of my face.
I'm just gonna smooth that right on.
Okay, so I feel like right now is the perfect time for me to do a foundation review because my skin is actually going through some things. So, and I think it's the weather. I've had breakouts and I have a whole bunch of redness going on. So this will be perfect. And I'm just gonna go ahead and start applying this. Okay, so first impression right off the bat, I noticed that it has a really funny smell. It's actually a bad smell. It has like a fishy after smell. Hopefully there's just not some defect in the one that I got, because I don't think I've heard anyone say that yet. But so if you have this and yours has like a fishy after smell, definitely comment that below. But that is one of the very first things I've noticed. Outside of the fishy smell, I can tell that it glides on my face really well. Like, it seems really smooth and creamy. The color that I got is 127 or Y335. I can already tell I'm probably gonna like this color. So the first thing I'm gonna do is just start blending this out. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use a foundation brush and then I'm gonna go back in with my beauty blender. Okay, so as I'm blending this out, I possibly could have gone one shade darker than this. So my initial reaction to this foundation, I'm actually surprised because so many people are raving about this, and I don't feel like I have a ton to cover, but I do feel like this is accentuating my pores. And that is one thing that I look for in a foundation, is that it has more of a smoothing effect to my skin. I don't want my skin, or my, especially my pores, to look better without makeup on than they do with makeup on, because then there's really no point. So the consistency of this foundation on my skin, it doesn't seem like I'm gonna be a fan of it, because it's actually a creamy foundation, but it's almost like it's setting powdery, and the creamy and the powdery is just not meshing well. And anywhere where I have that uneven texture in my skin, whether it be a pore or a blemish, or even dry patches of skin, it's accentuating that area, and that is definitely not what I want out of a foundation. So I'm gonna finish the rest of my makeup and see how this looks. Okay, so you can see here around my nose where it has that separation in the foundation, and around my pores, it's accentuating my pores. I do have a slightly dry patch here on my cheek, and you can see it's really accentuating that area as well. So this is the side of my face with the primer, and I'm noticing that I actually like the side without the primer better than I did with. And this is the side without the primer. So you can see the exact same thing. It looks a little bit better around the dry areas on my cheeks, but around the pores, it just does not sit smoothly on top of my pores at all. So I'm just not sure how I'm feeling about it. I will mention that this is completely natural lighting, so I have no other light sources outside of the window that I'm sitting in front of and my room light that is on the ceiling. So I'm gonna go ahead and finish my makeup. Okay guys, so I went ahead and finished up the rest of my makeup. I will tell you that my opinion of this foundation has not changed much since the first impression. It just does not sit on my skin like I would want it to, like I would want in a foundation. So the pros to this foundation, I like the fact that it does come in a stick form. I like the coverage of this foundation. I think it does have very pretty coverage, and I like the tone of this foundation. So I feel like the color has a nice skin tone. But I do feel like if you have any unevenness in your skin, that it is going to accentuate those areas. So around blemishes, around pores, anything like a dry patch in your skin, this is gonna accentuate those areas. At least it did on me, and I would not recommend this for someone with dry skin. At first, the consistency would make you think, oh, this might be really good for someone with dry skin because it does feel creamy, but I did notice a lot of caking up or separating around those areas that were uneven in my skin tone, especially dry patches. So my final verdict on this is this product does not live up to its claims for me. Listen, I'm a realist, so I'm not looking for perfection, and I know that a foundation is not going to give you invisible coverage, but this coverage, I feel like my skin actually, as far as the texture of my skin, looks better without any makeup on it at all versus with this on it. So that's definitely not what I'm looking for in a foundation. I do feel kind of let down because so many people raved about this and so many people really like this and have been talking about it on social media, but this was just not the one for me. So this is something that I will not be purchasing again. I'm not sure if I'll do the check back. It does say that it's long lasting. It might be long lasting, but as the fact that it doesn't look that great on my skin to begin with, like, I'm just not even sure. And also, if you notice right here, I had like that bump, I had a pimple right here, and now it's like flaky dry skin and there it's red. So when you first put this foundation on and you blend it out, it did cover that redness. It covered my broken capillaries, but now that it is sitting on my skin for just, let's see, I think it's been 15 minutes, I can see the redness peeking through already, especially around that area, and that could be because that's that unevenness in the dry skin right there where that blemish was. So guys, I know a lot of people really like this foundation. If you like this foundation, and if you don't like this foundation, I would love to hear from you down below in the comment section, just your thoughts on the foundation, I wanna hear if anyone else thought this had a funny smell to it, because this one definitely has a funny smell to it. The only type of skin I would recommend this for is if you have a pretty smooth skin texture. That means like when you touch your skin, it's pretty smooth, you don't have enlarged pores. Even, you know what, I don't even have enlarged pores. So your pores have to be like really minute for this not to show on your pores, because without makeup I think my pores look fine, but with this on top of it, I really didn't like the way it accentuated them. I feel like it actually made me look older. And if you have a really smooth skin texture, if you are normal to oily And that is how I think you could get away with this foundation. I know a lot of people think that this would be great for dry skin because of that consistency, but I would not recommend this for dry skin. I don't think I'm gonna be doing the check back for this foundation because I think we all know how I feel about it. But definitely comment me down below what you think, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.